Good morning, friend of mine. I am Pastor Hugh McKenzie, a pastor from the Seventh-day Adventist Church. A happy day to you and your loved ones. Every morning we share two chapters from the audio Bible narrated by Alexander Scorby and a devotional from one of the chapters shared. May you be spiritually blessed and refreshed as you listen. Please share the presentations so that someone else may be blessed. May God continue to bless you and your family as you listen every day. God bless you.
The Epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Ephesians, Chapter 2. And you hath he quickened, who were dead in trespasses and sins, wherein in time past ye walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience, among whom also we all had our conversation in times past, in the lusts of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together with Christ, by grace ye are saved, and hath raised us up together, and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness toward us through Christ Jesus. For by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. Wherefore remember that ye, being in time past Gentiles in the flesh, who are called uncircumcision by that which is called the circumcision in the flesh made by hands, that at that time ye were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel, and strangers from the covenants of promise, having no hope, and without God in the world. But now, in Christ Jesus, ye who sometimes were far off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace, who hath made both one, and hath broken down the middle wall of partition between us, having abolished in his flesh the enmity, even the law of commandments contained in ordinances, for to make in himself of twain one new man, so making peace, and that he might reconcile both unto God in one body by the cross, having slain the enmity thereby, and came and preached peace to you which were afar off and to them that were nigh. For through him we both have access by one Spirit unto the Father. Now therefore ye are no more strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints, and of the household of God, and are built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom all the building fitly framed together groweth unto an holy temple in the Lord, in whom ye also are builded together for an habitation of God through the Spirit.
Our text for meditation is Ephesians chapter 2 and verse 10. The Bible says, "For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them." Again, "For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them." Ephesians chapter 2 and verse 10. Today's message is entitled, "The Place of Good Works." The Place of Good Works. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we're asking in a special way that you would help us to understand this message so that our lives will stand in the right relationship to you as far as living for you is concerned. In Jesus' name, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, it is reported that personal debt in the United States is increasing at the rate of $1,000 per second, and that consumer installment debt has mushroomed to a point where it takes approximately $1 out of every $4 that consumers earn after taxes to keep up the payments, not including the home mortgage. For over 250,000 Americans, the burden of debt is so great that he or she declares bankruptcy. There are even more serious consequences of this financial tension created by debt. For 56% of all divorces are a result of financial tension in the home. Ladies and gentlemen, speaking of a different kind of debt, we need to understand how this relates to salvation. In other words, let no one take the limited, narrow position that any of the works of man, human beings, can help in the least possible way to liquidate the debt of his transgression. We should not even think that we can do works to liquidate the debt of our transgression. This is a deadly deception that we can do works, that we can offer payment for our transgression. Friend of mine, this matter is so dimly comprehended that thousands upon thousands claiming to be children of God are really children of the wicked one. Why? Because they will depend on their own works to earn them salvation. They think that they can do things to commend God to them. Like the Pharisee who stood in church and said, "Lord, I thank you that I am not as other men are. I fast twice a week. I pay tithe of mint and cumin. I am not an extortioner. I'm not an adulterer. I'm not even like this other worshiper, this publican across over there." He had his list of works to present to God. But the Bible said that the Pharisee prayed with himself. God was not hearing him. God always demanded good works. Yes, the law demands it. But because man placed himself in sin, where his good works are valueless, Jesus' righteousness alone can commend us to God. In other words, even the good that we do is so tainted with sin that even our good works apart from Jesus have no value. But the question is, but are good works of no real value at all? Is the sinner who commits sin every day with impunity regarded of God with the same favor as the one who through faith in Christ tries to work in his integrity? The Bible gives us the answer. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 2 and verse 10 that we are God's workmanship created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. You see, friend of mine, in his divine arrangement, through his unmerited favor, his love that we do not deserve, the Lord has ordained that good works shall be rewarded. In his divine arrangement, God has ordained that good works shall be rewarded. Revelation chapter 22 and verse 12 states, "And behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man according as his work shall be." Friend of mine, we are accepted through Christ's merit alone, through Christ alone, and the acts of mercy, the deeds of love which we perform are the fruits of faith, and they become a blessing to us, for men are to be rewarded according to their works. But those works must flow out of love for Jesus, they must be propelled by the Holy Spirit of God, and there must not be a conscious effort on the part of man that I'm going to do this so that I could recommend myself to God. It is the fragrance, the perfume of what Christ has done for us that makes our good works acceptable to God. And it is grace, God's power, that enables us to do the works for which He rewards us. You know, it's like if we're owing God $1 million, and then God gives us $1 million to repay Him the $1 million that we owe Him, because we couldn't get the $1 million ourselves. So God wants us to do good works to represent Him. But we cannot of our own strength do those good works, because they are tainted with sin and wrong motive. So God says, as you give your life to me, as you depend on me, I, through the power of the Holy Spirit, will enable you, empower you to do good works that are an outflow of gratitude for what you cherish that I have done for you. Friend of mine, we deserve no thanks from God. We have only done what is our duty to do, and our works could not have been performed in the strength of our own sinful natures. Because Jesus said in John chapter 15, verses 4 and 5, "Abide in me and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself except it abide in the vine, no more can ye except ye abide in me. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit, for without me ye can do nothing." So, friend of mine, Jesus is able to save to the uttermost. All that we can do toward our salvation is to accept the invitation given in Revelation chapter 22 and verse 17. The Bible says, "Whosoever will, let him take the water of life freely." Let him accept Jesus and this offer of salvation freely. Friend of mine, salvation is not worked for. Salvation is accepted. We say that again. Salvation is not worked for. Salvation is accepted. That is why a dying thief on a cross could say, "Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom." And Jesus tells him, "Friend of mine, when I come again, you will be with me. I will take you to my kingdom, to my eternal home." He couldn't work because he was pinned on a cross. And friend of mine, likewise, you cannot do 5 things to be saved. We cannot go to the small house behind the big house to do ceremonies to be saved. We say, "Jesus, come into my heart, come into my life." And then whatever we do after is a result of the fact that we are grateful for His saving love, and our works are not to earn salvation. Our works flow because we know and we appreciate the salvation we already have in Jesus Christ, because we have accepted Him as our Savior. Friend of mine, Jesus died for us on the cross to grant us pardon and eternal life. May our good works today be the outflow of a grateful life, because we have accepted Jesus as our Savior and we are happy that He has saved us. Let us pray. Loving Father, thank you for helping us to understand this important subject today. Bless that person who is seeking to serve you. May our works be an outflow of gratitude for what you have done for us. In Jesus' name, amen.
We trust that you were blessed by today's presentation. We would like to hear your testimony of what God is doing for you through this ministry. You can contact us by writing to The Word of Truth Radio Broadcast, in care of the Guyana Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, P.O. Box 10191, Georgetown, Guyana. Or you can call us on 226-4412. Again, you can write to The Word of Truth Radio Broadcast, in care of the Guyana Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, Post Office Box 10191, Georgetown, Guyana. Or you can call us on 226-4412. Until the next broadcast, may God bless you richly.